Hey boys, Adachi here, and we are back once again. Finally, I'm back from my vacation, glad to be back, but we're going to go over the new update real quick and what it all entails. Starting off, we have the regular bug fix thing, so if you want to know what bugs they are aware of, what bugs they are fixing and have already fixed, go ahead and check that out, but we're just going to take a look at these things here. Actually, starting off with the power-up packs, in my opinion, always skip these, they're almost never worth it. I don't think I've seen them worth it even once. But starting off, unfortunately we did not get the Christmas event. Funny enough, I decided not to cover the Christmas event over in JP, and then we ended up not getting it. So yeah, you could call that maybe a twofer for my predictions there. But we are getting the Invasion event, which this event is just so you can go ahead and farm up these monsters' souls. There's only going to be one active every couple of days, and then they're going to rotate out. So if you want to check out the exact scheduling for all these different souls, then check them out. But definitely clear those, get those clear crystals, and then they're going to all have a higher drop rate for the monster souls, which I would recommend building these up if you don't have like a bunch of units you're already building up at the moment, because you're going to want to hit those 12 units, get those three teams ready for when tower hits in the next month or two. And although these monsters aren't really great, they're still going to be able to at least fill up some slots, and you're going to be able to hit those max awakenings and those SC caps relatively more easily with the monsters than you would like gacha units and whatnot. But yeah, definitely farm those up. And then the next part is the Santa Theria banner. Now this banner is going to be heavily changed from the JP versions banner. If you're curious about that banner at all, I'm going to go ahead and leave one of those little video thumbnail things at the end of the video if you want to check out the original JP video. I'll also leave it in the description below. But essentially they went ahead and combined the two banners and made them into one. They changed some of the numbers around, and this skin, which is originally paid crystals only, is now going to be available through free gems as well. So yeah, I think they're trying out a whole lot of different ways to monetize the game, and I think that this is a pretty good way to do it since a lot of people seem to be upset about this skin. I will say though, if you are going to go for this skin, absolutely only go for this if you just want the palette swap right there. You just want the little cute black dress. If you're thinking that this is some meta breaking thing or it's some kind of OP piece of armor, it's really not, because when you get into endgame builds for mages, for the most part you're going to want to be slapping dual wield on them anyway, and they're going to lose that body armor slot, so you're going to be swapping that in for another weapon. This will then become entirely useless. So that's that. Looking at the gear, I'm not going to look into this. If you want to check out my analysis on all these things, then go check out the JP video that I did. But I'm going to go ahead and throw up a picture right now of some of the nerfs they did for Theria, because they did nerf her a little bit. So thank you, Greensburg, for this little bit of info. First thing he says is that the Theria's skill and trait is going to be on the same node in the global side, so I don't really know what that means, if that means like they're going to be included on the same node as far as her ability tree goes, so are they going to cost less crystals or what that means, but that doesn't seem that huge for me. Next up is they changed out light critical for light boost, so this one isn't a super big nerf, but that's going to lose you 3 SC if you eventually want to throw light critical back in there. But that one's not too crazy of a nerf. Next up, Magic Up Max is going to be swapped out for Magic Up 3. This one isn't too crazy either. They're both relatively easy to get, and funny enough, actually, Greensburg put in this cute little note here. It says, actually kind of a buff if you don't have God of the Dead, because Magic Up 3 is only available on God of the Dead, so you know, cup half full, half empty, however you want to see it. And then they did get rid of the Wand High Boost for Magic Defense Up 3. The Wand High Boost was the one that boosted the magic and the physical damage by a set percent. And honestly, that ability was pretty damn strong. This one's kind of the really big nerf on her, because Magic Defense Up 3, like, that's a weird one. You're never really going to throw that onto a mage as far as like meta builds go. But that was kind of one of the really big big abilities that really kind of overtuned her, so that really brings her down. And then her Carolite, her passive, which gave her a 20% light magic boost, is now going to be dropped down to a 10% light magic damage boost. Funny enough though, looking over at the Altama page, they also state a 10% boost, so I don't know if that also got nerfed on the JP side, but just a fun little tidbit there to look at. They also did patch in the new story update, so definitely go do that. Go get your crystals. There's no new nodes or no new maps being unlocked. You're just going to be revisiting old nodes and where they're going to unlock more maps for you to farm there, so new farming spaces. But that does mean there's no real like new side content and whatnot. There's no new shrines or anything like that. The only two big things I will say is the little purple summon that we got in the last story update, you are now going to be able to challenge the level 2 version of that to get the upgrade on that. And then there is going to be a new side boss included, which was the first high difficulty boss that was released over in JP. So this one is definitely going to be for you endgame players out there. It is going to be pretty damn strong, and I will definitely be covering that in a video in the future as soon as I take it on and take a look at it myself. So taking a look at the banner again really quickly, like I said, they condensed the banners from JP. Over on JP, they had a free gem banner and then they had a paid gem banner. They ended up condensing all that, so this is all going to be free or paid gems. All gems. It's so weird to try and separate those two things. But now, as for free to players, the any dupes you get of Theria, these are going to give you the 90 souls, and then the ether percent is now going to be at 10% for the dupes, of course. Over on JP, this was exclusively for the paid banner only, and then the skin here, of course, you can also get with free and or paid crystals. And then the rate up is going to be 0.5% for Theria, and then 0.833% for the Arc. Nothing different there. It is very standard as for every other banner that has released. And then the last thing I wanted to take a look at was the shop. One thing I did want to update from my JP video though is, yeah, you can buy Theria over on JP. It was in the little other metal shop though. I guess I forgot to check that entirely, but that was where you would actually get your guaranteed Theria. And you're going to see that here. It looks like they're making a change for limited units going forward, so that way you can also purchase souls separately. But you are going to just be able to buy the unit straight up. You're not going to buy the souls and then trade those in for the unit anymore. It's just going to be the unit right out. So you're going to have the Black Santa skin here for 80. You're going to have the Theria, the Arc, both for the 300 guarantee. And then they threw in a bunch of souls for whales here that want to go ahead and pick those up. As a free to player, I wouldn't really recommend grabbing these 10 soul fragments. They're not. That's not a whole lot. I would just go farm the side story instead. And then just kind of your standard regular old summon shop stuff here. They did not give us all the stuff over from the JP shop, so this is more what we're used to, and it's not as crazily whale overtuned as the JP shop was. And yeah, that about covers it. Last note I did want to end on though, this banner is only going on for a week, and do I think you should pull on it? I do think you should pull on this banner, because again, it is limited, and she is a very, very good mage, but she kind of is falling in line with along the lines of Zex and Dine right now. She's not crazily overtuned. She doesn't really eclipse them in any real strong way, but she is still a very solid light mage, definitely one of the best mages in the game right now, and she is also a really great support with all of those built-in support spells that she has. So yeah, definitely a good banner to pull on. And that about covers it all. If you guys do have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. Otherwise, thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one.